Burned, a Miraculous Ladybug fanfiction, part 13. Today's theme is New Look. If you have not heard the previous 12 parts of this story, you can find a link to them in the description box below. If you haven't already, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and comment down below in support of more fanfiction. Now then, let's get burned. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Cat Noir's heart was palpitating at the sight. What were the chances she had the same idea as he did? When he transformed today, Cat decided he wanted a slick back hairstyle, just to have something different about him. To his surprise, Ladybug showed up to the Akuma fight with a high bun instead of her trademark twin tails. Now he couldn't concentrate on the fight because he kept sneaking glances at her. The hairstyle did a great job of showing off her neck. Not only that, but he thought he saw her check him out. But it might be in his head. He didn't trust himself as a narrator when it came to Ladybug. "Pound it!" Ladybug said, raising her fist. Cat was so out of it that her action came as a surprise, and he gave the saddest fist bump in the history of ever. How embarrassing. She started talking about something else, but he couldn't concentrate. Her hair was distractingly cute. "Hey, so about what I said yesterday," he said, interrupting her. She looked away for a moment, her cheeks flushed as though she were embarrassed.
"Yeah, sorry."
"Don't be. That's not what he meant."
"It's just that, well,"
Ladybug sighed, obviously debating how to continue.
"You're the only person who knows me for me. And before you answer, I don't mean it in some kind of endearment or grand ideal. I mean that, of everyone who's ever met Ladybug, you're the only person whose relationship with me isn't that of idol or savior. Did that make sense?"
She was right. It was the same for him as Cat Noir, but somehow it was easier to deal with Cat Noir fans than those who held Adrian Agreste as their idol. It must be more important to her to have a partner than for him, because unlike his already idle lifestyle, Ladybug grew up with friends. People who loved her for her. No expectations. At least, that's his impression of her. He'd seen how awkward she was around fans when they first got their Miraculous.
"Okay."
His tone was soft. His emotions came second to what she was going through. He could keep playing her loving, platonic partner. That was his role to fill.
"I guess you aren't in the mood for takeout, are you?"
She laughed at his response and shook her head.
"I'll see you around, kitty,"
Ladybug said, pulling out her yo-yo.
"Catch you next time."
"Oh, and Cat?"
"Yeah?"
"I like the hair."
He felt his cheeks burn red under the mask, staggering his reply. Before he could thank her for the compliment, she was gone, leaving him with a racing heartbeat and the ever-present reminder of his feelings for her. The flame was only burning himself.
Whoa, hey, no, let's not do that. Sorry, my cat just stepped on my laptop.
"I'm so happy you waited until the end to make noise."
Anyway, if you hear little jingle bells in the background, it's the cats moving. I'll catch you next time, guys.